Hi, everyone. I'm Colleen Cosmo Murphy from Classic Album Sundays, and welcome to our special series with Jazz Cafe, Kind of New, in which we have great bands performing classic albums live. And tonight is a very exciting one. Fela, Kuti, of course, is beloved by so many of us, and we're really looking forward to hearing how it's going to be interpreted. And I thought it was quite interesting that Koola, Lobitos was the album that was picked, this compilation. As many of you know, in the late 1950s, Fela Kuti lived here in London, where he studied trumpet at the Trinity College of Music. And it was here that he met Tony Allen, the amazing drummer who he brought back, and they went back to Nigeria. They went back to a newly independent Nigeria in 1963, and at that time, high life music from Ghana had really kind of taken over, especially this guy, Geraldo Pino. And Geraldo Pino was a real showman. He was amazing on the mic. He also had a great sound system. He had a fabulous car, great clothes, and he was attracting a lot of the ladies. And Fela Kuti said he knew he had to get his shit together and quickly, because here is this guy on the scene who was really stirring things up. But at the same time, he was hugely inspired by him, and it really made him kind of up his game. But the thing that was interesting about Koola, Lobitos is they also brought in the London jazz and the American jazz that Fela Kuti and Tony Allen had really become accustomed to and been turned on to whilst they were here in London. So they were kind of a little bit ahead of the musical curve at that time. Of course, they would become much more ahead of the musical curve as time went on. But Fela, as a trumpet player at that time, he was into Miles Davis and Dizzy Gillespie. And of course, Tony Allen, as a four-limbed kind of drummer, was into Max Roach, Elvin Jones, and Art Blakey. So they were bringing something that was really, truly experimental and melding it with African highlife. And after that, of course, they also were exposed to the Godfather of Soul. And they brought some funk and some great rhythms into their music. And it has to be said as well that James Brown was also in turn inspired by Fela Kuti. So Fela would eventually switch from trumpet to saxophone. Apparently it was better for his kissing technique. And his music would eventually move into a more expansive and kind of politically and socially charged kind of music, which he of course called Afrobeat. They went in 1969 to Los Angeles, Koola, Lobitos. And there they met Sandra Isidore, who turned Fela Kuti onto the writings of Angela Davis and Malcolm X and exposed him to the Black Panthers. And it was then that he really made a conscious decision to use music as a weapon. And of course, when he returned back to Nigeria, his whole musical style changed, became much more politically charged, and he really kind of was revolutionary in so many different ways. But it's interesting because tonight we're going to back up to the music that really kind of foreshadowed this transition. And we have a wonderful artist with her band who's going to be performing tonight, and they're going to perform certain selections. She works with Jazz Jamaica, Courtney Pine's Venus Warriors. She has her own quartet, and she also has an album, The People Could Fly. Please put your hands together for Camilla George. Oh, man. Now, a lot of people here are familiar with Fela Kuti and Afrobeat, but why don't you just, you were born in Nigeria, and why don't you describe to us what high life is?
Well, my understanding of high life is that it originated actually in Ghana. I think also because you mentioned Jazz Jamaica, I mean, the interesting thing about high life is the kind of the clave feel, the 3-2 clave, which is very similar to calypso. I think there's quite a link between calypso and high life. And that's how I would describe in terms of how you're hearing it.
Gotcha. Now, you could have picked so many of Fela's 1970s albums that people are familiar with, you know, from Gentleman to Zombie to... There's a huge array of choices there. Instead, you rewound to the 1960s and you picked Koola, Lobitos. Why is that?
Yeah, I think it's interesting because it's like the beginning of the Afrobeat period. It's like the birth of Afrobeat. And I think it's quite interesting. Hopefully, people will enjoy the here in the very beginnings of what would become a massive movement.
Now, how were Fela and his band ahead of the musical curve in Nigeria at that time? Because they were playing high life. This guy, Geraldo Pino's on the scene, and he's really stirring things up. So what were they doing that made them a little bit different?
I think it was, as you mentioned, he was studying at Trinity in London, which is where I studied, and actually quite a lot of the band that are playing tonight went to Trinity. And he, I think he brought a lot of the jazz elements from some of the clubs, the music that he'd been listening to here. It's also got quite a lot of soul, like you mentioned, the James Brown vibe. So I think it's a mishmash of different things.
Mm-hmm. Now, does it sound like it's a musician who's trying out different things and trying to find his kind of own imprint and his own musical style?
Yeah, I think so. I think it's like it's at the beginning. He's obviously left college. I've definitely been there. He's trying to find his voice, but I mean, it's Fela, so the music is great. Anyway, it's amazing. Yeah.
And what do you think their effect was in Nigeria in the 1960s? I know you weren't there. You were too young, but maybe your parents know.
Well, my mom is literally
just. Is she? We need to ask her. Did Fela have a great effect in the 1960s? Maybe you're too young, too.
She's a young, yeah, very young. I think there's obviously a huge political effect. But I think also musically, because as you mentioned, it's just this new sound, which is a mishmash of stuff that he heard when he was in the UK and US influences that he brought to Africa.
Yeah. Now, of course, when Fela came back from the United States and he came back to Nigeria, he was a completely different person. He was completely changed. What was the effect of that Fela on Nigeria?
Ooh, I don't know. That is a very hard question.
Well, with the Kalakuta, with the communal compound and how political he was, I mean, do you think that he really kind of... It seemed like he was really not only trying to shake things up musically, but he was trying to shake things up politically as well,
and
socially.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, as you mentioned, he'd had experience of... he'd got into the writings of Malcolm X, the Black Panthers. That obviously was would have a big impact when he came back to Nigeria, I think.
Yeah. Now, when you picked Koola Lobitos, this compilation came out not so long ago, maybe a couple of years ago, and it was all put together from like different 7-inches and different albums. That's a lot of music to go through. How did you decide how did you pick out what you're going to perform tonight?
Yeah, there's 39 tracks. I just had it on repeat for weeks, and I've chosen my favorites, so hopefully people are going to enjoy it.
Right. And can you give us a little hint about what you're going to do? Are you going to kind of play them as Fela played them and the band played them, or with your own fresh interpretation?
We're going to stick quite close to the record. I do have a couple of original tunes in there, and we have one later Fela piece. It's all I'm going to say that I'm sure everyone will know.
And you're going to perform some of your own music too, I hear?
Yeah, we're going to perform one track from my new album, The People Could Fly, and one track from my previous album, Isang.
And what else is coming up in your own future? What's coming up with your quartet?
It's no longer a quartet. I've expanded it to include the amazing Shirley Tete on guitar. We've got Cherise Adams-Burnett on vocals. Omar sang on my album. We've got lots of stuff coming up. I'm hoping to go back into the studio to do some more recording and writing. We recently did a gig with a kora player, so I'm quite interested in that, mixing in kora with the sounds.
Fantastic.
So yeah, we'll see how it goes.
Well, good luck with everything. And and one last thing, where do you really hear Fela's legacy and his musical legacy now?
I think London's having a moment. There's definitely a huge Afrobeat scene at the moment. We've got some of the members from Kokoroko in the band. There's so many people out there doing this music and bringing it, giving it new life.
And so many young people. It's really fantastic.
It's
There's so much great energy.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much.
Good
luck with the show. And please give your hands a round warm of applause to Camilla George.
lote sa pupa de te a la dayo babo poe aladoui te la se la fe aladoui se poni poni.
Hello. Right. So that was our first tune, Bonfo. So I'm just going to introduce this amazing band. I'm so excited to be playing with this many heavyweights. On the keys, we've got Sarah Tandy. Guitar, the amazing Shirley Tete. Jihad. Extra fans. Jihad Darwish on bass. Winston Clifford on drums. Cherise Adams-Burnett on vocals. Sheila Maurice Gray on trumpet. My name's Camilla George. You're going to continue with Pure Fela. the next tune is entitled Onifere Number 2. Jackie, going to move on to, I think, one of my favourite tunes on the album. And this is entitled Ferret.
Thank you. Hello. Well, I lied. That was kind of my favorite tune, but the one that's coming up is my absolute favorite tune. It's cool. Yep. I've got many favorites, but this is really the favorite. This is called It's High Life Time.
Time, jump for joy, and the swinging club. It's a brand new place that brings the grace. It's got the beat, it's got the heat. It's high life time, it's morning time. Jump for joy, at the swinging club. It's a brand new place that brings you grace. Got the heat! It's got the beat, it's got the beat. It's a brand new place, it's brand new place. It's brand new place, let it race. It's got the beat, to let it race. It's high life time, it's morning time. Jump for joy and swing and clap. It's a brand new place that brings the grace. It's got the beat, it's got heat. Ow! Thank you.
Once again, the amazing Cherise Adams-Burnett. We're going to take a short break and we should be back with more music, more high life, more Fela. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hello, we're back. That was a tune called My Baby Don't Love Me. We're going to continue with actually one of my pieces, which is from my new album. So I hope you like it as much as you've liked the Fela stuff. Otherwise, it could be a bit of a flop. This is called Tapping the Land Turtle. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. We're going to do one more of mine, which is about a West African spirit who takes on the form of an evil mermaid. And this is called Mammy Water Returns.
Thank you.
Thank you. Sheila Maurice Gray. We're returning to Fela now. This for our last tune. I'm just going to introduce this fantastic band again. Winston Clifford. Jihad Darwish on bass. Shale Tete on guitar. Yeah. Sarah Tandy on keys. Sheila Maurice Gray on trumpet. I'm going to bring back our fantastic vocalist, Cherise Adams-Burnett. Calling Cherise to the stage. Woo! My name's Camilla George, thank you very much.
Thank you.
To the stage. My name is Camilla George. Thank you so much.